Welcome to PJ's Q&A section. You must have this experience when you have two parts, seems a very good model, nothing go wrong, and then you try to do Boolean unit and they pick up this part and this part. When you hit enter, instead of Boolean unit, some of the part is disappear. Today we're gonna talk about the reason and how to fix this issue. When you use the Boolean unit and one of the part is disappear, that indicated the part remain has issue. What does that mean? We can always check on our model first before we do the Boolean unit. Look at the right over here, it say close solid poly surface. And then look at the one in the middle, it say various, meaning this one has been grouped. So let's ungroup it. And then we want to check on it one by one. This prong right here say close solid poly surface. This one here is close solid poly surface. So the prong seems to have no problem. But if we take a look on this, it say open poly surface. And then we look at this called open poly surface. So that means if your model is has naked edges, is open foam, Boolean will usually one part will be disappear. So let's go take a look. Let's hide all the part that has no problem. Let's go ahead to hide all of this. And let's just take a look on this. Now, if you see something like this, even though the foam seems is close, but that little extra there is considered a naked edges. What my naked edges mean is if you go to analyze and you go to edge tool, you want show all edges and it will give you a dialogue look like this, right? And then that will show what is the naked edges. Not only there, you may also see on all four corners. So this one is not going to work. Right, so now how we fix this? We could trim the surface by exploding everything and try to trim them. But because this surface is cross to the other side, you see that little angle hanging there. So that might cause the problem if we try to trim it in this way. So we are not using the surface trimming each other. Usually that will work. So how do we fix this? We need a little bit help with the prong. So let me bring in back the prong. And then if we turn it into the ghost view, we're going to see that is the area, the problem area is completely covered inside of the prong. So what we are going to do is we are going to use this, all four of our prong as our cutting object, and we are going to go in and trim all the problem area. So you're going to trim it off there, coming into this corner, trim it off here, both top and the bottom, because the top one has an issue too. We're going to trim off all of them. Once you trim everything off, you're going to see that hole there. So what we need to do is we need to join all of this. But because there's a surface in between, we are not able to join. So now we're going to do the reverse, is we are going to use those two as a cutting tool. And we are going to insert and trim off the surface in between. And sometimes it's so hard to click on the right place, and you can do is you can turn on a wireframe instead. So the way you're going to click is you are going to click on this ISO curve. So that way will be easier for you to see which is which. And we're gonna come over here as well. We're gonna trim it off all of them by click on the vertical ISO curve, or where actually the seam is. All right, so now we trim everything off, we're able to join them. Let's check one more time at the object, it say no naked edges. So we can bring up everything back, turning back to the ghost view, and then we try to do Boolean and see what happened. So now it's working, it's into one piece. I hope that answered your question. Please like and comment and share my video, that helped my ranking on the YouTube. If you haven't subscribe it. Don't forget to click the little bell to get the notification when I have a new video. Thank you, and I will see you next.